Hello, I'm Red Hawk. Welcome to Journey with Red Hawk. Today I'd like to talk to you about one of my favorite subjects, big bucks. There's nothing more I like doing than hunting a big buck on his own territory. A 4 or 5 year old deer, now that's really going to test my hunting skills. He's smart, he's calm, he's patient, and he doesn't wear a watch like we do. He doesn't have to get home on time. So to get into their home, you have to really understand them. Today I'm very fortunate to have some film shot by Dr. Leonard Lee Rue III. Some footage of deer using a licking stick, a deer with glands, a deer with interdigital glands. I'm going to share all of this with you right now. This chart shows all the scent glands of the white-tailed deer. The forehead, preorbital, nasal, salivary, penis sheath, metatarsal, interdigital, and tarsal gland. I believe the forehead gland, interdigital, and tarsal gland are the most used glands on the white-tailed deer. This is a licking stick. It's literally a gold mine for hunters. You find them in obscure places, usually along acorn ridges or in hidden spots where bucks will hang out. If you notice, the buck is depositing scent from his forehead gland and then he licks it off. Every buck in the area will come by and check this out, deposit their own scent, and lick the other scent off from the bucks. If you find one of these licking sticks, be sure to set yourself up downwind and spend time, because I guarantee you, every buck in the area is going to come by and check it out. This is a perfect example that shows the top 6 inches rubbed clean on the licking stick. Here's a buck really going at it. Watch this guy. He doesn't stop licking that stick, depositing the scent from his forehead glands. Boy, I like to be in that tree right behind him. Here's one of those hidden signs I always talk about. This buck is rubbing his forehead scent glands on his tree. I truly believe that they do this to just about every tree in their area. You have to look for slight tine marks on the tree. It's hard to find sometimes, but we will see tiny scrapes. If you can find these trees and follow them, you could literally trail a buck to his bed. Notice how hard he's pressing the forehead gland and preorbital glands against that tree. He's depositing his scent calling card. This buck looks like he's been fighting a little bit, if you notice on his jawline. But he's also depositing that same scent and licking it off while making a nice rub. This big guy's licking an overhanging branch, a sure sign that he's getting ready to make a scrape underneath it. This is a tarsal gland of a mature white-tailed buck. Notice the dark brown color and how it runs right down to his hooves. This is how it gets that way. The buck urinates on both tarsal glands at the same time, rubbing them together and activating the scent molecules that are attached on the tarsal glands. This creates the scent that we all know during the fall rut. And here she is, what's on every buck's mind during the rut, a doe sunning herself on a beautiful ridge. This buck is in full rut. Look at the way his neck is swollen up. Here's a buck that's on the trail of a hot doe. He's going to follow closely behind her and not leave her side. She's either going to agree to mate with him or she's going to chase him off, one or the other. Now these two bucks are sparring. Notice the calm demeanor. Their ears aren't back all the way. Their legs aren't really dug in. Not a lot of aggression going on here. This is how you can tell sparring from fighting. Now these guys are fighting. Look at the back legs dug in, the strength, the shoulders, their necks. This is a fight. That nose never goes to sleep. It's always working 24/7. Checking the air constantly. This buck is Fleming. He's testing for does that are in estrus and ready to breathe. the scent molecules actually go up under his lip and are caught by nerves, which can tell him that a doe is in heat and ready to be bred. I hope the scent glands that you've seen in this video help you in this upcoming season, and that you have this buck standing broadside in front of you at 10 yards.
That was some awesome footage. I'll tell you, those bucks don't get that big by being dumb. The one thing I've found out is, the older a buck gets, the calmer he gets. And what I mean is, the 1.5-year-old bucks, the 2-year-old bucks, they'll follow the same runs as the does, and when you get in the woods, they'll bust out right in front of you, flip the tail, start running. These big guys, 3, 4, 5 years old, they calm down. They start patterning you. They know where you walk into your street tree stand, how you come out of your car. They hear all this stuff, 4 o'clock in the morning. These guys are smart. Sometimes you have to get in this thick stuff. A 4-year-old buck, 5-year-old buck can get in a patch like this, lay down. As long as he has food, water, and shelter, he can spend the whole season in here and move at night while you're gone. The best way that I've found is to get on the ground, get on eye level with them, and get in their home. And what I mean is, you have to kick them out like rabbits sometimes, literally. I've seen bucks lay down flat in the grass with their antlers hidden by buffalo grass and brush and let guys walk right past them. I saw these 6 guys doing a drive in Michigan, and they walked past a 20-foot bush. If they saw the buck that was laying inside that brush, I think they would have threw their guns in the river, man. I'll tell you, that was some buck. Well, till next time, get in there, kick that buck up, do a little still hunting, get eye level with him, have some fun, take a kid hunting, and I'll see you next time. Aho.